بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وصل اللهم وسلم على خلفاء نبيك وأوصيائه وأهل بيته وأحبته، علي أمير المؤمنين وقائد الغر المحجلين، وعلى البضعة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين، وعلى سبطي نبي الرحمة وسيدي شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين عليهم السلام، وعلى علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي، عجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف وسهل مخرجه وجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه. عباد الله، أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وقضينا إلى بني إسرائيل في الكتاب لتفسدن في الأرض مرتين ولتعلن علوا كبيرا، فإذا جاء وعد أولاهما بعثنا عليكم عبادا لنا أولي بأس شديد فجاسوا خلال الديار وكان وعدا مفعولا، ثم رددنا لكم الكرة عليهم وأمددناكم بأموال وبنين وجعلناكم أكثر نفيرا. إن أحسنتم أحسنتم لأنفسكم وإن أسأتم فلها، فإذا جاء وعد الآخرة ليسوءوا وجوهكم وليدخلوا المسجد كما دخلوه أول مرة وليتبروا ما علوا تتبيرا. صدق الله العلي العظيم.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
Today is the universal day of Quds, Jerusalem, dedicated to this important city. Why this city is important to us? This city is not only a Palestinian or Middle Eastern or Israeli city. This city is a universal city. Has no ethnic or racial or even religious boundaries. Cities like Jerusalem, like Mecca, Medina, they are universal for mankind. This city was أولى القبلتين for the period where the Prophet ﷺ was in Mecca, and 17 months, the first 17 months of his residence in Medina, he and the Muslims used to face Jerusalem in their prayers. And then after that it changed to Mecca. A priest the other day asked me, why did you change your Qibla from Jerusalem to Mecca? Good question. Muslims, they faced Jerusalem in the beginning. And then, قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهَكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَلَنْوَلِّيَنَّكَ قِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا فَوَلِّي وَجْهَكَ شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. The reason Allah wanted the Muslims to begin their prayers in the beginning of the journey of Islam towards Jerusalem is to establish this link and this connection with the previous religions. This is a declaration that Islam is not alien from other religions. It's a continuation. It's the integration of Christianity, of Judaism, of the message of Ibrahim alayhi salam. But then why then God changed it? Let it be towards Jerusalem. Allah says in the Quran, the first temple, the first masjid on earth is Kaaba. It's not Jerusalem. إِنَّ أَوَّلَ بَيْتٍ وُضِعَ لِلنَّاسِ لَلَّذِي بِبَكَّةَ مُبَارَكًا وَهُدًى لِلْعَالَمِينَ. فيه آيات بينات مقام إبراهيم. Reference to Abraham. And Abraham was before Solomon. The one who built the temple in Jerusalem was Solomon. Before him, 800 years, Ibrahim alayhi salam built the temple and the masjid in the awwala bayt, the house of worship. It was in Mecca. That's the original house. So this is the reason. It's not about discrimination, but it's about priority. Mecca was the first temple, the first house of worship that has been ever built on earth by the patriarch Ibrahim alayhi salam. So this is one importance. أولى القبلتين وثالث الحرمين. Again, it is sacred. On the night of Mi'raj, the Prophet has to go from Mecca to Jerusalem, from Jerusalem to heaven. He couldn't go non-stop from Mecca to heaven. Why should he go to the hub and change airplane and go to the heaven? Why? Allah couldn't take him right away from Mecca to heaven? Again, this is another statement, another declaration that the Prophet is connected with previous Prophets and Anbiya. Because Jerusalem was the seat of many numerous messengers of God. Allah wants to say that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not alien from them. He continues the same journey. We want him to come to Jerusalem. سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَانِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى. The farthest mosque. Masjid al-Aqsa الَّذِي بَارَكْنَا حَوْلًا. So he had to go to Al-Aqsa, the farthest mosque, and then from there he goes, continues his journey into heaven. Mi'raj. The first one was Isra, nightly journey. The second is Mi'raj, ascension to heaven. Again, to say that we are one family. We are one family, we are one community. In Surah Al-Baqarah, if you have friends who are Jews, Christians, people of book, read this verse for them. In Surah Al-Baqarah 136, قُلُوا آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْنَا. Not only we believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we believe in God, whatever God has sent to us, وَمَا أُنزِلَ. This is very interesting. وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلِ وَإِسْحَاقِ وَيَعْقُوبِ وَالْأَسْبَاطِ. Asbat are the tribes of Israel, the 12 tribes, the descendants of Isaac. We believe in what had been sent to them. Part of our religion, part of our faith. والأسباط وما أوتي موسى وعيسى وما أوتي النبيون من ربهم. Every prophet, whatever they received from the Lord, we believe in it. We respect it. We follow it. وما أوتي النبيون من ربهم. لا نفرق بين أحد منهم. We have no bias. We have no discrimination. We respect all of them. لا نفرق بين أحد منهم ونحن له مسلمون. We submit our will to God. The question of Jerusalem is not whether it's an Arab city or a Jewish city. It's a city that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever is closer to Allah has the right to claim that city. If the Jews, they have the right connection with Allah, they worship Him according to what He likes, not what they like, then they have right. If the Muslims, they worship God and they have better connection, then they have the claim. Allah says this city is universal. And Islam is not about race or color. Islam never says Arabs or Jews or white or black. Islam says, what does He say? يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا. When it comes to God, there is no difference between this geographic area or that geographic area, or this culture or that culture, or this race or that race. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا. The closest one among you to God. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. For God, there is no question of race or blood. It's the question of piety and righteousness. serving God and serving the humanity. But this city, unfortunately, has been lost because Muslims are fighting each other. Muslims, they do not stand up to their rights. Today, almost in every Muslim country, there is some sort of fighting and bloodshed and war. During the month of Ramadan in countries like Algeria, 2 days, two madahib among them, after Salatul Taraweeh, immediately. As if Salatul Taraweeh tells them, go and kill each other. Immediately, the news says, after Salatul Taraweeh, they go, they destroy. Did you hear that in the news? 30 people were killed in a province called Ghardaya in Algeria. And during the month of Ramadan, during the nights of Ramadan. This is unacceptable. This is what makes others stronger than us. Not only we lose Jerusalem, we might lose other cities if we remain like that, if we remain divided. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Yesterday was only Jerusalem. Today, every Muslim country is bleeding. Every Muslim country. What is the solution? Where do we go? The solution is to ask America, the State Department, to help us. The White House to help us. Allah says, وَاَعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ. If you are united, if you respect each other, if you take care of each other, you are not going to be divided, you are not going to be weak. Stand up for your dignity. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. We stand on this day with all the oppressed, not only the Palestinians. Yemen is under attack. An attack which is worse than the Israeli attacks against the Palestinians in Yemen during the month of Ramadan. With airplanes that purchased with Muslim money. The F-16s that are bombing the people of Yemen, they carry the banner, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. They belong to the Saudi Air Force. This is in Yemen. The same thing in Syria, the same thing in Iraq, the same thing in Egypt, in Tunisia, and other places. Allahumma inna nashku ilayka faqda nabiyyina salawatuka alayhi wa alihi wa ghaybata waliyyina wa kathrata aduwina wa qillata adadina wa shiddata alfitan bina wa tadahura az-zamani alayna. We have to pray for the unity and the dignity of the Muslim Ummah. The only solution is this in this book. Wa'tasimu bihablillahi jami'an wa la tafarraqu. Hold fast to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Go back to Him. Go back to Him. These, the last 10 days of Ramadan are the nights of dedication and devotion, intensified devotion. Don't forget to pray. When you pray for yourself and your family, also remember you have another family in Yemen, in Syria, in Iraq, in Palestine, in other places. Pray for them. Pray for their faraj, inshallah. Pray for their peace. Pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings an end to these miseries of the Muslims and the non-Muslims. Yesterday I was reading that the total number of the Syrian refugees reached 7 million. 7 million, 7 million refugees from one country? Where is Islam? Where is when Allah says in the Quran about the Prophet, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We say in our Adhan, أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. We claim that we love Prophet Muhammad. Where is this love? Show me, where is it? Where is it? 7 million refugees from Syria, small country. Many of them, they lost their parents, their fathers, their guardians, living in miserable condition. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ يَعِظُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، تابع اللهم بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات، إنك مجيب الدعوات. اللهم وحد كلمة المسلمين على الخير والبر والصلاح والتقوى يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اخمد هذه الفتنة بين المسلمين. اللهم نجهم من الحروب والكوارث يا أرحم الراحمين. من على مرضانا بالشفاء والعافية. فك أسرانا وسجناءنا وارحم لاجئينا يا أرحم الراحمين.